Are studying about MS Paint. Previous class you have read about it, MS Paint program. MS Paint is a drawing program and we can draw our pictures in this program. Okay. So first, how to start MS Paint? For this, when you start your computer system, your desktop screen appears and there is your start button. Click on it and click on all program and click on accessories. Okay. Accessories. After clicking accessories, it opened its program and you see the MS Paint program is here and click on it and your program is open. Okay. Now, first we know about its part. So, as usual, the upper bar is title bar. This is upper top bar known as a title bar. There is a three control button: minimize, maximize and close. When you open first time your MS Paint program, their title is untitled paint, and when you save your drawing with a file name or drawing name, then it appear title also. This is paint options. Is a some quick access toolbar. This is used for quick accessing. From here we can customize our quick access toolbars. If you add other button, then you can use from here. This is paint option button. Here there's a different type options for your MS Paint: new, open, save, save as, print, and there is other options, the exits also. New, from here you can create your new picture or drawing. Open, from here you open your created picture from your hard disk or disk drive. Save or save as, you can use these options to save your picture. Save is save the current picture, and save is this is use your picture as format like that: PNG, JPEG, BMP, GIF, or other format. Print option. Print option is used to print your picture as a hard copy on the paper. Okay. Send in an email. This is an option used when you connect with internet. Set as desktop background. This option used to apply your picture as a desktop background. Property, this is used to display the options of your picture or property. Okay. About paint, this is used for provide the information about your MS Paint program. And exit, this option is used to exit your current program. Okay. Now, there is a two main group, home group and view group. First, we start from home tab. Home tab, it contains their different options like clipboard, image, tool, shapes, and this is the color option. The clipboard, this group is consist the cut copy paste option. Okay, and cut copy paste option, this is used to move your picture from one place to another place. So we use cut copy and paste option. And copy option, shortcut key is Ctrl plus C, and cut shortcut key is Ctrl plus X, and paste Ctrl plus V is shortcut key. When you copy your image or any picture, so it also remain at previous place, and when you paste it on another location, okay, and cut option when you used, then it not display at previous location your file or picture image, and you can paste another place. Okay, now this is a tool group is consist mainly six tool. Okay, first is pencil. This is used to freehand drawing. Okay, and you can use this to draw any drawing. Okay, and you can say that it is free from hand tool, or you can draw any type of image. Okay, second is fill with color. This is used to fill color in your drawing or figure. For this, you remember that when you draw any picture, remember that when you start your point for drawing, so your figure must be closed. Okay, like that you can say that start and end point is meet each other. When you select fill with color, this is a color bucket, then it's appear when you click on it, and select color from color group or edit color if you select any particular color. So click on it. Okay, if you click your figure, like this is not a closed figure, so color is fill all the drawing area. Okay, we undo your work by using Ctrl plus Z. Okay, so like that. Okay, and you can Select any color from color group to fill your object. Okay. Like that. Next is text option. Text option, this is used to type a text in your MS Paint. Okay. For this, you first click on this option. Okay. Click on this option for type text. Okay, and hold your mouse left button and drag it like that. Now a text box is appear and the mouse cursor is blink in this text box. When you are typing a text, it also open the text format option. Okay, like the text style, text size and other format. So for this, first you type here. Okay, now when you want to formatting on this sentence, select it and select from here any text style. As you can see that it changing in text box. Okay, any select, and you can change the size of font. If you want to click bold, so click on bold, italic, underline it or strike through if you want. So it apply on it. Again select it. If you want to change the color of your text, then you can select from here. Okay, like that. Okay, again transparent or opaque. This option is applied, and the work of this option is it is display your text or not. If you use transparent, it display your text. If you use opaque, then it disappear at background. Okay, again, this is next tool is eraser tool. Eraser tool is used to erase your drawing if you want to erase it. Okay, so for this you click on eraser, and now this is your eraser, and you can erase your drawing like that. For this you hold your mouse left button and move it freely, move it on your drawing if you want to erase that it. If you want to increase your eraser size, for this you can use control and plus key. Okay, so your eraser size is increased and you easily erase it. If you want to again reduce your eraser size, then control and minus sign use, so your eraser is reduce its size. Next is a pick color. Pick color, it is used to pick a color from one object and to apply another object. For it example, like we can select any shapes. Okay, if you want to pick this color, so click on it. And this option is used to pick a color from picture and use it for drawing. You can select any picture and copy color from this option, and you can fill in this object. Okay, and this is magnifier. This option is used to zoom in and zoom out your figure, or you can enlarge your picture. Okay, this is the simple tool of your drawing. Next is brush. Brush, it contains different type of brush options, and in this option they are used for also drawing. You select any type of brush options, and according to your point of brush, and you can use this. Okay, like that. and select any color like that. Like that. Like that. Okay. Like that. Okay, the brush is used as a painting brush, and you can draw a drawing by using these options also. And another brush is airbrush. It is used to spray the color in your drawing like that. Okay, these are the tool from home group. Now our next group is shapes group. For this we use new drawing. Okay, now this is shapes group. This group contain the different type of shapes like line, curve line, oval, rectangle, rounded rectangle, polygon, triangle, rectangle, diamond, pentagon, star. Okay, so you can select any type of shapes from this or this, and when you select any shapes, it seems that there is a outer boundary like that. It means it is selected. So you can format on it as your requirement. So there is a other format option, two type of format options: outline and fill. Outline, this is change the boundary of your picture like that. You can see you can enlarge your picture by that. Click on here, the mouse pointer is changed, then you can drag it from here and it increase your picture. Now you can see that when you change your outline or a boundary of your picture, and you can change it like that as we select. Okay, fill, this is the option to fill the color. Okay, so it fill the color of your image. This is the size of outline also, the point scale size, and you can select from here also. And you want to fill your color, select fill with color option, select color, and like that. Okay. This is the shapes option. According your requirement, you can select any type of shapes like that. This is the curve line, and you can use it for according to your requirement. Okay. Or in color option, there are different type of color options which is used to fill your color in your objects. These are two options, first color one and second is color two. First color is a front color or a foreground color, and second is a background color. This is color is used to fill the shapes. When you select any shapes and you want to fill color, so this color is used. And the second color is a background color. This color is used for background options, like this is your background area. So this is your second color option. If you want to change your background area, then you can also change the background area. Okay. And edit color option. From edit color option, you can see there's a basic color options. Okay, if you want to custom your color, then you can customize your color. You can select here your color. Okay, and from here you can add to custom color also. So this is the edit color option. Now our next important group is image group. Image group, it contain selection options, resize, crop and rotate. Okay, so first we for this we open a picture to apply this. Okay, now we use this picture to apply this. Selection option contain first rectangular selection, freeform selections, select all. Select all, this is select the all the picture. Okay, freeform selection and rectangular selection, this is used to rectangular shapes like that, and you can select like that. If now you can cut and copy by selection. This area is selected by using rectangle selection. If you want to in this area cut, copy or delete, then click right on it, cut option, it cut the selected picture, copy, it copy the selected picture, crop, it also cut your remaining part of this picture inward. Okay, delete, it delete the selected part of the picture. Okay, like so first this is okay, and this is a free from selection. Free from selection, you can select the as your requirement your section like that. Okay. Okay. So first we select by using rectangular selection. Okay, like that. Now this is crop selected. Okay, now you want to crop it, so it crop the remaining part and the selected part is save. Resize or free from selection, you can select the area which you want to save like that. Like that. Okay. Okay. Now is a select all option. When it's selected and you want to invert selection, so this option change the current selection. Unselected portion of image get selected after using the command. Right. Okay. Resize option, by using this you can change the size of the picture by horizontally or by vertical. So in percentage you can change from here, or by pixel you can change from here. Okay, so you can change 50 or okay. Now this is change its size. Rotate option, it can rotate a degree by 90 left or 90 right, left, like rotate 180, flip vertical, flip horizontal. So flip and rotate is different. Flip means it move the image suddenly into different position. Okay, it's change the position of the image, and rotate it turn the image around the angle. Okay, this is the difference between the flip and rotate. This is the main tools of the your MS Paint in Home tab. Second tab is View tab. View tab, it contains zoom option, ruler, grid line, status bar, full screen. First is zoom in, zoom out. Zoom in and zoom out option is used to display your picture in large or small. When you click on zoom in option, it display your picture in large, and when you click on zoom out, it display picture in small, and 100% it zoom it 100%. Okay, and next is ruler. When you click on ruler, it display the ruler like that. This is scaling of your program, horizontal and vertical. When you uncheck it, then ruler is disappear. Grid line, it display the many lines in your working area. If you uncheck it, then it disappear. Status bar, when you click on it, then the status bar is display here, and you can see it status of your drawing, like a pixel and size and a zooming option. Full screen, when you click on full screen, your picture is display on full screen. Okay, and by using escape button, you current position, you again come. Next is when you complete your drawing, this is another part is for your save option. Click on save, then select your save as option like that, and select your picture with name. Okay, print option. If you want to print this work on a hard copy on a paper, then select on print option. It display three option: the print, page setup, and print preview. First we use the print preview option. For why? Because of it display the position of your result at a paper like that. Okay, that. So when you print your drawing on paper, this type of result is display. Okay, from here you can close your print preview. Again, go to print, then click on print. So it open a print, and you can select a printer from here, and give the number of copy from here, and page range from here. Okay, all selection or pages. Okay, or current page, and give click on print. And this is a simple shortcut key for print is Ctrl plus P. Now set as background. If you want to set as a background of your picture, then click on set as background. And this is the three options for background option: fill it, tiles, on center. So select any option as your requirement, and it asks you from you must save the file before choosing the desktop background. You click OK, then it set as a background like that. Like that, okay. And exit. This option is used to exit the program, and it exit your current program. And so this is the your MS Paint. Keep practice on it.